The home ownership gap between black and white households is wider than it has been in 50 years. People of color are unequally affected by the affordable housing crisis, have been hit harder by COVID-19, and have been subject to a history of racist government policies. It's the nastiest threesome since the Three Stooges. Despite the CDC moratorium, landlords have still found ways to continue pushing out tenants. The ban only suspends eviction of certain renters who have suffered financially due to COVID, leaving room for landlords to use bullshit tactics to kick people out.
My husband filed for unemployment, still didn't get no unemployment. So basically, it left me in a situation to do stuff by myself, try to keep food in the house, and try to pay the rent.
After paying the rent late in April and in May, her landlord told her she was being evicted.
I'm asking, like, how is you going to evict us and be still paying our payment? He said, I just want y'all out of there.
The landlord said Anderson paid her rent late several times, and she was violating her lease because her 20-year-old son wasn't on the initial paperwork. He had come to live with her when his college closed because of the pandemic.
What? A 20-year-old living in an apartment where they're not on the lease is a description of like half the friends on Friends. The CDC and the Justice Department have said that landlords are not required to make their tenants aware of the moratorium and can start the process while the measure is active, essentially ensuring landlords are prepared to evict on January 1st. Landlords are the only people the three ghosts of Christmas don't even bother with. They just check the "sorry we missed you" box and off for drinks at TGI Fridays. Unsurprisingly, throughout the pandemic, some landlords have resorted to illegal intimidation tactics.
Some landlords engage in intimidation tactics to get tenants to leave, which sometimes leads to what are known as self-help evictions.
Self-help means the landlord has not resorted to starting a court case, has not done the preliminary notices, has not filed the court cases, just literally locked out the person or lock them out and throw their things out as well.
This is illegal in almost every state in the country.
Not only is this cruel, it's also the worst form of self-help I've heard of since I read the 5 love languages and found out my love language is German. Willst du meinen Arsch? I asked. Nein, they answered. Regardless of when tenants are ultimately evicted, they'll face a massive bill of back rent and potential late fees, which could amount to $34 billion. And if millions of people are suddenly without homes, the pandemic will almost certainly be made worse.
Our home and our shelter is what keeps us safe from this virus. We could see a massive wave of evictions that come in January and February and March. If we have an eviction crisis, I can't see any way that we won't have an explosion of cases across the country.
Of course, more evictions will lead to more cases of COVID. You would think it's common sense, but this is the country that thought Matt Damon could just go buy a zoo. I don't know, Matt. Maybe go get your zoology PhD first, like the rest of us. Evicting millions of people during a pandemic is bad for everyone. We need Congress to pass a new comprehensive stimulus package and extend the moratorium. Furthermore, we need massive rent relief strategies, legislation that protects renters, and a renewed investment in affordable housing. The eviction crisis is affecting people all over the country. Go to justshelter.org to learn about how you can get involved in your community. Full Frontal is helping our own by partnering with Coalition for the Homeless to help raise funds to provide eviction prevention for people living in New York City. When you buy our new t-shirt from samanthab.com/takeaction, proceeds will go directly to their organization. Because housing is a human right, not just at the holidays, not just during a pandemic, all the time. If you liked this video, hit subscribe and leave a pleasant comment below. Let's ride out the rest of this nightmare year together, okay? Okay? All right.